everyone. I wanted to do a video today about something that some people might look at this title and think that I'm absolutely batshit crazy about, but in my book, Ryan Murphy can do no wrong. Now, let me preface this video by saying that I'm not just some Glee fan who loves Ryan Murphy because of what he's given me on TV. No. I've actually been watching a lot of Ryan's work since I was really young, and it actually all began when I started watching NipTuck, which a normal about, I don't even know how old I was, should not be watching, but even now, I don't think that anyone who's under the age of 18 should really be watching that show. But I'm glad I did, because Ryan Murphy is an amazing storyteller. Now, this extends into the people that he works with, whether it be the other executive producers, the writers, the actors, the directors, the DPs, the costumers, the makeup. He surrounds himself with very good people and creates amazing stories which allow people to lose themselves, whether it be for 1 minute, 1 hour, 1 week, 1 year, 1 season, 1 series. That's what Ryan Murphy is really good at. So in that regard, Ryan really can't go wrong. Let's just take a look at the listing of shows Ryan has worked on and see how many of these you've ever watched. These are just his producing credits. Popular, Running with Scissors, Pretty Handsome, NipTuck, The Glee Project, Glee, New Normal, Normal Heart, The Town That Dreaded Sundown, American Horror Story, Murder House, Coven, Asylum, and now Freak Show. Those are just shows that he's produced and movies he's produced. If you talk about how much you hate so much Ryan Murphy for what he does to one of your series, but you still watch that series, you really can't fault Ryan for doing his job. And that extends to Brad and to Ian and to everyone he works with on all these shows. So Ryan Murphy has really done his job as a storyteller, and I'm really grateful for it because I have made amazing friends because of shows that Ryan has done. So if you have made a friend because of a TV show you've watched of his, if you have bonded over an issue that a character had, if you've loved a song that was sang, if you loved the way something looked, if you loved anything that has been at one part of one show he has had a hand in, you really can't fault him for doing his job and being an amazing storyteller. So I know a lot of Glee fans aren't too happy with the spoilers that have been coming out from season 6. I myself am not happy from what I've heard so far, but I'm not gonna hold it against them. I'm gonna wait, because sometimes there are those spoilers that are so far-fetched out there that until we get the episode, we won't really know what happens. So to my Glee fans, I know we're all getting really anxious and nervous about the season, and some people are already swearing off the season before we've even seen a single shot of a single episode or a single still. I'm gonna say, let's wait for the first teasers and judge it from there. Don't judge things based on spoilers. This kind of goes with any TV show in general, actually. Could you say that you're gonna swear off Doctor Who because you heard one spoiler about the Doctor with Peter Capaldi that you didn't like? Probably not. If you said that you were never gonna watch Supernatural again because you didn't like a demon they were gonna fight, I'm pretty sure that's not gonna happen. Or if you're not gonna watch Sherlock because of something Watson potentially might say. I don't know, I don't watch the show. You probably won't swear it off though. So why swear off a show that you've been loyal to with a creator who's been really good to his fans and to creating stories that we all love, some that we might not love so much, but creating generally stories that we love? Why swear it off based on a spoiler? That's why I love Ryan Murphy stuff, because even through spoilers sometimes, I'm pleasantly surprised with the outcome. Now, this also really makes me excited for the premiere of American Horror Story, which is tomorrow night, so it is the 7th right now, which is why if you're probably watching this, it might have already aired. So if it's already aired, go look to check to see, I think it's like FX Now or whatnot, they have it on there, or you can watch it on Wednesday nights at 10 p.m. Check your cable listings below, I don't know. But I'm really excited for shows like this. I'm really excited for season 6 of Glee, no matter how much hate there is. I'm really excited for American Horror Story. I'm really excited for any project Ryan does, because I'm always able to find something to enjoy about whatever project he's working on. And this extends to Brad and Ian and a lot of the other actors that we've fallen in love with because of projects Ryan has done. So if you're telling me you hate Ryan Murphy because of one storyline, I think you might want to reevaluate why you hate him. Because it's not him you hate. It's the storyline you hate. So this was kind of a jumble of my feelings towards basing things on spoilers and Ryan Murphy and my love for all of his shows. But, I mean, that's how it is. It's kind of one content creator talking about another content creator that she appreciates. So if Ryan Murphy ever saw this, I appreciate the stories you tell and the creations you've made for the general public to fall in love with, whether it be a character, a story, a song, a movie, or a feeling of euphoria while watching something. So thank you, Ryan Murphy, Brad Falchuk, Ian Brennan, Dante De Loretta, all of the peeps who work on shows that I really love. Thank you. So that's my little spiel. Don't forget to hit subscribe. Give this video a thumbs up. Let me know in the comments up below. So that's my little spiel. Don't forget to hit subscribe if you haven't already. Give this video a nice big thumbs up. Let me know in the comment section below what your favorite Ryan Murphy show is. And if you have a specific episode or character that you love, let me know also below. And I will see you guys in the next video. Get ready for American Horror Story. I have a couple of really cool videos coming out about that. And I will see you guys later.